gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Frederick De Silva. Woo!
Hi. Good evening. How are you doing? How are you doing? All right, let's begin. I need the help of four volunteers. If you want to come, just raise your hand. Yes, madam, you can come. Yes, and you want both of you? If you want, yeah, both of you. If you want, you can come. All right, come here. So we have four volunteers. Ladies and gentlemen, give them a big round of applause. Yeah, have a seat there. Very important that we have not prearranged nothing before the show. We are not friends.
Nope.
And you look to be happy about that. All right, and I would like to start maybe with you, sir. Would you like to think of someone who is close to you, someone that you know really well, someone that you know the actual age, how old is that person, someone that you know the story, everything. There is no way for me to actually tell you something about that person, right? Okay. Yes. Madam, I've got for you a lot of books. You can check this one if you want, and you can have a look at those books. Make sure that all the pages and all the numbers are different. Madam, you're going to open the book at any page. In that case, it's 24, and just tell us a number page. Open the book where you want. What's the name of the page?
92.
92. Are you happy with that?
Yes.
Yes. Madam, would you like to open your book, page 92, please? And madam, would you like to imagine a bigger clock in your mind? Look at me, with the time changing and changing and changing. And in a moment, I will say stop. And you're going to stop that clock for me. Look at me. Here. It's changing and changing. And it stops right now. Think of how many hours, how many minutes is there. Think in digital also. You have the time in your mind? Okay, good. Madam, are you page 92?
92.
92. Would you like to put your finger on the very first word of the page?
Yes.
Don't say nothing out loud. Remember that word and close the book. Perfect. In a moment, to give a maximum of proofs for the audience here and to see if I can guess your thoughts or not, I'm going to ask you to write down what you're thinking of. I mean, you will be able to write down how many hours, how many minutes you have in your mind. Okay, put that in digital. Okay, fold it in half and in half again. Make sure it's impossible to see through the light. Madam, you will be able to write down the word that you have.
Thank you.
Okay, secretly, each of you will be able to write and complete the information in big letters, please. Fold it in half and in half again. Madam, do you play cards? No. In my deck of cards here, there is one card which is face down. Very important to say absolutely honestly, you don't know what is the card that I put face down in my deck, right? Yes, look at me and think of a suit, spades, heart, clubs, or diamonds. Think of one of them. Imagine the card and imagine the number from 1 to 10, which is on the card. Yes, or it can be a picture card if you want, or an ace, but think of one card. You have one? Cool. Did you write the time in digital? Yes, did you write your word? Did you write the name of that person? Make sure it's impossible to see through the light. Anyway, I've got here some envelopes for you. This is for you. All right, this is for you. Madam, look at me. Am I correct to say if I can see the letter T in the word that you are thinking of?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Please take your piece of papers, put them inside of the envelopes, lip them. This is the French method. All right, and raise your hand with your envelopes. Raise your hand with the envelopes, raise your hand, and raise your hand. Perfect. Madam, you have one card in your mind? Yes, this is my deck of cards. I'm going to give that deck of cards to this gentleman here. Do you have a pocket?
Could
you? Yes, could you put the deck of cards into your pocket? Perfect. Madam, think of one card, and right now, you're going to do exactly the same thing. You're going to write down the name of that person, put it inside of the envelope, and close the envelope for me. She will bring you the pencil. So, the person that you're thinking of is a man, am I correct to say that?
Yeah.
Yes. Imagine that I could see in your mind, I'm getting a man from 30 years to 40 years, is that correct?
Yeah.
And I can see the letter D in his... Really? Madam, the word that you were thinking of, I'm also getting the letter R. Yes, and the word that you have in your mind is not an object, am I correct to say that? It's not an object, but it's something that you can feel in some way?
I can definitely.
All right, cool. Are you thinking of the time? Repeat the time in your mind again and again and again. All right, yes. The card. But not about on the business cards. Okay, fold it in half again. Write down the card that you have in your mind. So you still have the deck of cards? Yes, in your pocket?
Yes.
All right, perfect. So now we are ready. Let's begin. So, you're thinking of a man from 30 years to 40 years. I can see the letter D. Actually, the name starts with the letter D. And I can see the letter. Okay, I'm trying to give you more details about that. You're thinking of a name. I'm going to write here name. You're thinking of a word. The word. I'm getting the letter T. The letter L also. It's still not an object. It's a feeling. It's a kind of negative feeling, in some way. Not always, but yes, it could be. All right, to a lot of people, I'm going to write here word, and I'm going to try to give you more details in a second. You are thinking of one time. Did you write the time with the minutes also? Yes, and you are thinking of a card. Did you write down the name of the card? And remember, he has a deck of cards with one card, which is face down. Let's see if the impossible happened card. Sir, the person that you are thinking of, from 30 years to 35 years old.
Yeah.
Would you like to put your hand on my wrist? This is not an automatic reading, but think of that person for me. Go. Would you like to take that? Five letters?
Yeah.
Did you prearrange something before the show?
No.
How old is that person? 34?
Yeah.
Sir, I ask you to think of someone who was close to you, and you were thinking of David.
Yeah.
Look at what I have.
Oh my God.
David! David, is that your brother?
Yeah.
It's your brother?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's keep going, madam. The time that you have in your mind, the time that you have in your mind, I'm getting the minutes very close from a quarter to half an hour. The minutes, yes. And if it's in the morning, it should be very, very early in the morning. Maybe from two to six. Yes. All right, madam. The word that you have in your mind, I'm getting something right now. I don't know why. It's a three-digit numbers here. I'm going to write down here. Nothing about digit numbers, right? No? Okay. So forget that. I'm getting a kind of negative emotion feeling. I'm sorry. Okay. Wait a second. Would you like to open your envelope, please?
Okay.
Yes, you can rip it. Okay. Unfold the paper and tell us out loud what was the word that you were thinking of. Say it out loud.
Trouble.
Okay, this is a kind of negative feeling. It's not an object. Trouble, I was getting the letter T, L. Well, there is. I didn't write trouble. Would you like to show us? It's a three-digit numbers. I don't know what, 2, 7, and 8. What could be the link between the word that she has in her mind, trouble, and 278? Well, whatever the word was, this word should be in a dictionary. And madam, you have a dictionary. Okay, but wait a second. I don't know. Would you like to open the dictionary, page 278? The even pages are on the left page. We are looking for trouble. Yes, trouble, page 278. What is that? 278, trouble! You can keep that as a souvenir. And never say that I never give you nothing. All right. Okay, madam, the time that you have in your mind right now. Let's try to do something different. Actually, it is something like 10 and 42, obviously not the time that you were thinking of, but I asked you to imagine the clock with the time changing and changing and changing again. So, do you know what's the time that she has in her mind? No? Would you like to take the watch without looking at it, and you will change slowly the time?
Just face down.
Yeah. And madam, I need you to think of the time and repeat that time in your mind again and again and again. And whenever you want, you will just say stop. Stop. Would you like to stop and push the button, please? Are the minutes on? Don't look at it. 20 minutes?
You're crazy.
Wow. I'm going for that.
I changed it a little.
Okay, so I'm going. Okay. So I'm going to change also for that. Would you like to take that for me? Did we prearrange something before the show? No. I ask you to think of a time, and you will think of. What is that? 4:20. That's 4:20. Wait! You will become crazy because this gentleman just took the watch she was thinking of, and when she says stop, he stopped the watch. Your thought was 4:20. Sir, would you like to tell us what time is that?
4:20,
ladies and gentlemen! Well, the most difficult, I was not trying to guess what you were thinking of, but you actually tried to do the same thing. When I ask you to think of a suit, I say it can be spades, diamond, heart, club, spades, diamond, heart, club, spades, diamond, heart, club. So I was trying that in your mind jump a heart card. Is that what happened in your mind?
Yes.
Be absolutely honest. I'm going to tell you exactly what happened in your mind. And you will say yes or no. You don't know really now, but when I will tell you that, it will jump and you will say, gosh, this is exactly what happened. I first ask you to imagine a number from 1 to 10, and I wait a second before I say, oh, it can be a picture card or an ace, because you was already thinking of a number. And when I say a picture card or an ace, it confuses you a little bit, but you stay on your first impression, and that's the number that you're thinking of, right? Would you like to give me the deck of cards? I'm going to take the risk. I am not going to tell you what's the card that I put face down, but you're going to do that for me. In a moment, on a count of three, you're going to tell me what is the card. Believe that you can do that. If it's not the right card, it's not the right card. It's okay, but if it is, you will hear huge and fantastic applause, because we have to admit this is absolutely exciting. On a count of three, one, two, three. What's my card? The Four of Hearts. Is that your final answer? Four of Hearts?
Yes!
That's it! Thank you!